Dali Days, A Short Journey in Blue and White. There is a place in southwestern China, nestled between mountains and a lake, and it is drenched in blue and white. Clouds like cream poured into a rippling mirror of skies, dissolving in long lazy tendrils. A cup of creamy skies on a December day. What more could I ask for? This place is my winter hideout, but it's not the tropical island most might seek. If anything, its ice-capped mountain peaks welcome me like a long-lost child, 8,000 kilometers away from my home in Bavaria, Germany. I know I am a stranger here, but my eyes, so familiar with the fading silhouettes of mountain ranges and lush green vegetation admiring itself in the perfect mirror of still mountain lakes, beg to differ. I recently learned a new word, apricity, the warmth of the sun on your skin during winter. If I had learned this word anywhere else but here, I might not have fully grasped its meaning. Now I shiver through early morning walks, willing the pale sun to climb higher. When it does, it burns my skin, but never reaches my bones. Trees, seagulls, humans, we all follow the sun's slow ascent like sunflowers, filled with devotion and hunger. The local Bai minority is famous for its tie-dye products. Textiles stretch against the sky, blending into it. Not a veil, really, more like a toy for the wind to play with. The Bai women hang their artworks out to dry, snapping the cloth smartly to take out the wrinkles. White blossoms bloom in indigo fields. By day, Dali is stingy with his warmer colors, keeping everything in cool shades of blue and green. At night, it pours all its reds, yellows, oranges, and purples across the canvas of dying light. Dali nights are clouds catching fire, mountains burning, pale moons hiding behind trees, stars falling into our high lake, bobbing on waves and waving back at the darkening sky. Lights dotting our high lake's midnight coffee black, twinkling words of rest and warmer days. What more could I ask for?